Hi, I'm Chris Edwards. Welcome to this week's Tennis Warehouse vlog. US Open's in full swing. So this week I was thinking of looking at some maximum stability shoes, something you're gonna really want out there on the hard court. So let's have a look, see what we've got. First up, a shoe which I think you're gonna see make a really good run at this year's Open is Novak Djokovic's shoe. This is the Adidas Barricade 7. Really like the shoes, very, very stable. Through the midfoot, so a lot of the stability features of a shoe are going to come from the kind of the chassis. Think of the middle part of the shoe as the chassis of the shoe, and this one, it really locks the foot in. You've got that classic Barricade claw technology right up there towards the forefoot to help you find the stability you need when you're making those aggressive lateral cuts. And the Barricade's always featured Adidas's torsion system, and so that really does beef up that middle part of the shoe. It makes it really locked in around the heel, so you can see shoe resists twisting exceptionally well in the rear of the shoe. We have that TPU material comes up from the middle of the shoe, comes all the way up and around the heel, really does lock the shoe in very well. This one's also a very durable shoe, so it's gonna last a long time out there on the hard courts as well. Great shoe, love the styles that we have in this shoe right now. I love the red, white, and blue one that we have, as well as this one here. It does feature the Djokovic symbol right there, his little sig on the tongue. Another shoe, really fun colorway, this one with the ASICS Gel Resolution 5. This one has a bit more flex and feel. It's gonna break in a little quicker. That Barricade takes a bit of a break in. This one's a bit more comfortable on the first few wears, and then comfort kind of evens out the more you get into both of these. Again, this has got a great chassis to it, nice TPU through the shank of the shoe right here. And that extends, again, just like we saw in that Adidas shoe, up around the heel. This one comes up much higher up around the heel. It makes it nice and supportive right there in the back of the shoe. You can see, again, it's not going to twist a lot. So when you make that aggressive lateral cut, you're going to get very locked in. This one does have a much more flexible area up in the forefoot, so it's nice toe-off, very fast-feeling shoe for a stability-minded shoe. Again, very durable. Great option out there on the hard courts, and it's a really fun one right there. Love the color story on the outsole, and pretty much all around on that shoe right there from ASICS. Next up, a shoe I really like, and I think it's a bit of an underrated shoe out there, but it is a very fast and supportive and comfortable feeling shoe too. And this is the Lotto, the Ultra 4 Speed. And what makes this shoe really stable is basically its cushioning system is a TPU-based system, and it has this SynPulse. So you have this ellipses right here, and that compresses as you, as your weight hits the court. And it kind of gives you a nice spring to it too. And they put this little wave in here as the technology evolved. You can just see that wave is there on the lateral side, and it's not on the medial side. So the shoe is designed to compress more on the medial side. So as your foot comes down, it's going to compress more this way than it will that way. And that's going to really help you prevent ankle roll. So it's very supportive and stable right the back there in the heel. And again, you see the more TPU coming up around the heel to really support the back of the shoe. And this one's got great torsional stability to it. It's nice and durable, and again, like I said, really fast feeling shoe. You'll see this one in the likes of David Ferrer out there on the Pro Tour, and I love this colorway right there, and that Samba, white Samba colorway. Now a couple of shoes from some racket brands, and this is the Yonex Power Cushion shoe, and they're Pro, and you'll see Stan the Man rocking this one. I'm hoping he hits his stride in the Open, finds some form and makes a good run. And love the orange color pop right here. Little silver and black accents. Again, it locks the foot in nicely. It's got a little bit more flex to it than some of the others, but it has a nice TPU piece, comes really high up around the heel. So it does give you a very nice supportive ride back there. And then a nice blend of stability, support, breathability, and some flex up there too in the front of the shoe to really help you get going on that first step nice and quickly. Quick look at the outsole, you can see that really solid TPU shank is going to offer you some really nice protection under your arch. So when you're sprinting around, your arch is going to be well protected. And a quick look at the medial side right there from Yonex. And then last but certainly not least is the Prince Warrior. This is a very stable, supportive feeling shoe. It does require a little bit of a break-in before the upper materials start to flex and move with your foot really well. So I like to wear the shoe around for an hour, a couple of hours maybe before I take it on court. And it does have really nice the TPU straps right here on the lateral side and medial side of the forefoot. It really help cinch that shoe in around your foot right there and give you great support stability when you're running around. Again, it's got a good chassis to it, so it resists that torsional flex very well. Offers quite a comfortable ride too, with the nice midsole material right there, extends all the way around, and it's pretty springy, so you get some nice cushion as you come down from your hard landings on the court. Good breathability from this one, ton of mesh through the tongue of this shoe. Again, it's very, very durable shoe out there on the hard courts. You can see that it's got that nice beefy shank, and that really does help it with its stability. That's it. We've got plenty of other stability shoes on our website, but you really can't go wrong with one of these five. Thanks for watching, and I'll catch you next week.